Hey guys, welcome to round one. We are gonna mulligan this and keep this. We don't have a fetch land for the Deathrite Shaman, so hopefully the opponent helps us out. That's already happening. And then our curve isn't exactly impacted, even if we did not have a land in the graveyard for a minute. Like, we would still have either Ooze or Abrupt Decay on turn two. Although, if he fetches here, we could play a turn two Liliana. Assuming we didn't want to play around Daze. But if it became apparent that our opponent was playing a combo deck, turn two Lily would be pretty good. Swords to Plowshares, okay. See what he does on turn two here. Probably something Abrupt Decay worthy, I would imagine. Either Stoneforge Mystic or Young Pyromancer. He could be on Miracles, but usually Miracles doesn't fetch out a Wasteland target. They usually, it's usually like a just a if absolutely necessary sort of land. So we're still missing our third land. Our opponent hasn't played us anything to Abrupt Decay. He did play a basic island from his hand, which implies Miracles. I'm just gonna play this top and hope he doesn't have Spell Pierce for it, and hope that it sets up our next land for either the Deed or the Liliana, whichever we deem is more important at the end of his turn. Both pretty solid. Deed can, like, break up the counterbalance combo, and it can also prevent the opponent from winning with Entreat the Angels. End of turn, Brainstorm. Interesting. AJ Soccer would throw a fit. Sometimes an end of turn Brainstorm is fine. Like, if you don't have a shuffle effect, sometimes it's okay. Usually not in this situation. Usually you do it if the filtering matters and you're not going to have a mana open for a while. Sometimes you can do it if you've got, like, a critical mass of filtering effects. Like, if you've got a hand of, like, triple Brainstorm or something like that. It doesn't look like that's the case, though. So, who knows? Spin this here, Topperino. Swamp Bayou. Alright, that's alright. Now we gotta decide what we're gonna jam into play here. I think I'm just gonna play Liliana. I don't think the Scavenging Ooze is gonna be very good. I'd like to just play Lily and uptick it and discard the Ooze. I guess just playing the Ooze gives me a little bit of pressure if he's going to tap out for Jace on his turn. Actual counterspell, that's fine. One's got four cards in hand. Yeah, if he taps out for Jace here, I'm going to be in real rough shape. Set a stop on my upkeep just in case I need it. Doesn't look like he's playing a Jace deck, though. Like, if Miracles is going to play a Volcanic Island, it's going to do it just for, like, a light splash. So usually you don't fetch it out. Which is what he did. I don't know. I'm just going to draw my card, play Pernicious Deed, and spin on his end of turn. He could have put me on Nickfit, and then he could be aggressively fetching out his dual lands, figuring that I will thin out the basics from his deck later on. That could be a reason for him to be, like, fetching the Tundras and Volcanic Islands, actually. Now that I think about it. So he's got Snapcaster Mage Counterspell, which is a little ugly. But not the end of the world. So he gets a little bit of value here. It could have maybe been prevented if we'd just been a little bit more patient. Played out our Ooze past the turn. Make him use a removal spell on it or something. At this point, I'm pretty sure he's playing Miracles. He's playing actual Counterspell and Snapcaster. He could be playing that Gifts Control deck from a long time ago. It was kind of pushed out by Blue-Red Delver. He could be testing that. That deck was playing Snapcasters and these other cards. And since Treasure Cruise got banned in Legacy and Gifts Ungiven didn't, this would be an interesting way to take advantage of that. Anyway, Spinning Top, find Liliana, a Veteran Explorer, and a land. Veteran Explorer doesn't seem that good here. I kind of like Liliana. Yeah, I'm just going to draw that. He didn't have Spell Pierce for the last couple of turns, and I'm pretty sure he would have cashed it in if he'd had it, so I'm just going to jam. Play this card, see what happens. The only real downside to playing this Liliana is that I edict him and now the Liliana is weak to Bolt. But at least I'm getting my 2-for-1 back, I guess. Yeah. Whereas if we spend some turns like developing the Ooze and Abrupt Decaying his Snapcaster or whatever, then when we play Liliana we can uptick it and it's out of Bolt range. The fact that he's playing Lightning Bolt means that he's not playing Miracles though. Yep, it's that Dig Through Time Control deck that I mentioned. So that deck wins through Jace, I believe. I believe it just Jace locks people, which is fine. It's a fine win condition. Our deck is a little bit weak to Jace, specifically, because, especially since we're not playing the Thrun as a Green Sun Zenith target. I've played the Thrun in Jace-heavy metagames. It matches up really poorly against True Name Nemesis, though, so I didn't put it in this version. If I was worried about Jace going into the new metagame, I would probably try and compensate by playing more Maelstrom Pulses in the main deck. Maybe even shaving an Abrupt Decay to fit more Maelstrom Pulses in. Okay, Stoneforge Mystic. I think they play like 2 Stoneforge Mystics and a Batterskull, so not surprised to see that card. Yeah, Batterskull entered the revealed card zone. I wonder if I could pop this out, and then people just showing up can just see it. Yeah. People paying half attention to this video in the background. I know those people exist. Let's see, Abrupt Decay, Land, Veteran Explorer. I don't really like any of these cards, so I'll draw the land. Right now we only have... Oh, he delved away the Snapcasters. There's no creatures in any graveyard. Not a thrilling scavenging ooze. We were gonna run it out. Just have the one Snapcast or Stoneforge Mystic to eat. When I play this card, I want to be able to eat 2 creatures, at least, to keep it out of Lightning Bolt range, because I don't think Lightning Bolt's very good against me otherwise. So I'm just gonna pass the turn back. It's gonna do something. Another end of turn brainstorm, sure. Yeah, I suppose end of turn brainstorm's a little bit better in his deck because it lets him hold up his mana on my turn completely. And then, like, the brainstorm itself is just like a 1-mana, like, minute amount of filtering draw card. Like, it's not as powerful as it could be, but it's also filling up his graveyard for the Dig Through Times. And the more he chains Dig Through Times together, the better his deck looks. So if he already has another Dig Through Time in his hand, the end of turn brainstorm without a shuffle effect makes a lot of sense. Anyway, Batterskull, sure. So the way this deck has historically beaten Batterskull has been to... I'm just going to cast a Veteran Explorer. That's fine, I guess. The way I've historically beaten Batterskulls in the past is popping a Pernicious Deed for 5, and then he has to return the Batterskull to his hand, and then you either, like, Cabal Therapy him, or Liliana him, or him to Turok, and get the Batterskull out of his hand that way. Which sounds wonky and super grindy, and it is. It is all of those things. I'm going to spin top now, just in case there's the Miser. Maelstrom Pulse is the third card down. It's not, it's just more decays. And I don't think decay is very good right now. I mean, neither is Veteran Explorer. Like, gets him more lands to balance his Batterskull and whatnot, but I'm just happy he's not, like, Jace Fate Sealing himself, I guess. I guess Jace Fate Sealing isn't especially good with a top in play, but I was a little bit worried about a Swords to Plowshares there, but not much I could do about it. So the Abrupt Decay is just a fog. I'm just gonna draw the Veteran Explorer again. I don't know why I spun here. Try that line again. Lead with Scavenging Ooze. And then play Veteran Explorer. And this prevents him from snapcasting back Swords to Plowshares on the Veteran Explorer. And then we're just going to pass the turn. Okay, he does have Bolt for Ooze. I'll exile something. No reason not to. Gain a point of life, I guess. Or no, I'm going to exile... Well, if I go to exile the Snapcaster Mage now, he just Snapcasts... Okay, no, that doesn't do anything. Yeah, because the Veteran Explorer is still on the stack. Cool. Yeah, exile the Swords to Plowshares. So if his plan was to Snapcast back Swords to Plowshares, he should have let the Veteran Explorer resolve, and then bolted my guy. And then, okay, he just naturally has a Swords to Plowshares in hand. Okay, that's fine. So he gets to hit us for 4, down to 13. Which is fine. The only life points that matter are the last ones, right? And he's already eaten a few bolts. So our life total isn't under a ton of pressure, even though he gets to attack with his Germ willy-nilly. We've got some Fogs on top of our library. Fog, aka Abrupt Decay. Okay, and he chose not to shuffle with his Ponder, in case people were curious about that. We drop down to 13. He goes up to irrelevant. His life total is pretty irrelevant. Like, if we're going to win the game, we're usually just going to win it with a lot of things. Okay. Yeah, I guess I cast Liliana. No, maybe I don't. Maybe I don't do that. Yeah, I do. I do. But I don't edict him. If this resolves, I'm just going to uptick. And then on his turn, I would tap top to draw the Abrupt Decay to kill the Germ, which I might end up doing anyway. Looks like he's responding with a Dig Through Time, eating up his graveyard. Very reasonable reaction. So he doesn't even have to find an actual counterspell here, although he does have the mana up for it. If he just finds a Force of Will, then he's in pretty good shape too. If you find, I think Counterspell plus Snapcaster is his best draw here. We still tap top to draw Abrupt Decay for the Germ, but then he can, like, just put the Batterskull in the Snapcaster Mage later down the road. And then he has, like, Snapcaster Mage for Counterspell for when we replay our top. Like, he'd be in really good, in real good shape if he could set that up. So maybe I don't even, tap this. Maybe I just draw the Decay naturally. But 9 life is kind of iffy. It's starting to get boltable, just with like Snapcasters and Lightning Bolts, even though he only has 2 bolts left in his library. It starts to become a more realistic thing that could happen. Or maybe he gets, like, a batter's gold germ in hit later when I have to tap out for something. Anyway. Be very happy if Liliana resolves. It does. It's gonna uptick. Which I don't think he expected. I think he maybe found a Snapcaster Mage to, like, eat the Edict or something. He discards Supreme Verdict. That's not very exciting. I guess there's... I'm trying to think if there's a reason to Sorcery Speed activate Tom. Can't really think of one. Maybe if he draws specifically, like, Thought Scour for his turn? I don't know. Abrupt Decay should be able to kill Batterskull. That's not true at all. I'm pretty glad Abrupt Decay has the restrictions that it does. Someone asked me once what card I would ban in Legacy. And I said Abrupt Decay, not because it's, like, a card that needs to be banned, just because it's a card that I would, not like to have to build around anymore. Like, I would like to just be able to not care that Abrupt Decay exists in the format. Okay, he has Jitten there. Interesting. Interesting. The last version of this deck that I saw only had Batterskulls. Anyway, so we're gonna lead off with just my casting Tom. He doesn't respond at all. I'm going to uptick Liliana again. And we're just going to hopefully grind him out of cards this way before he finds a Jace. Liliana can actually beat Jace if you have some pressure to accompany it. He has to discard Lightning Bolt. That's really good for us. I'm going to spin top now. Not that it really matters. Whoa. We do not have a land in our graveyard. That is the worst. I guess we could, like, chump with the Dryad Arbor for a turn, or, like, Liliana Edict ourselves or something. Yeah, how do I not have a land yet? This game is ridiculous. I think there's, like, 9 fetches in here or something like that. Anyway, maybe I should up the count because I've got this sweet mythic in here. So I'm going to put you on top. Just going to order it like it is. And then, if he end of turn bounces Batterskull, I'm just gonna tap top, kill his Stoneforge Mystic. So he doesn't get to cheat it into play. And he didn't, in fact, bounce it. Interesting. Maybe he just wants to equip and attack the Liliana. That would be pretty good for me. I'm not gonna lie, that would be amazing. And surprising that he didn't bounce it, though. I think having the extra creature in play would be pretty strong. Yeah, he is going to equip. I'm just going to do this now. Oh, we could draw Dryad Arbor and then just uptick Liliana to discard it. And then use the mythic to get it back, get a 5/5 or whatever. How does this thing read? When Titania Protective of Argoth enters the battlefield, return target land card from your graveyard to the battlefield. Oh, the land has to go to the graveyard from the battlefield. Okay, so we could play Titania and then, like, Liliana Edict ourselves. He showed us a sweeper, though, so I don't know how all-in I want to get as far as that goes. I do kind of want to draw Dryad Arbor next turn of the available options. I definitely don't want to play the 5/3 until I have a way of... like having a fetch land or something. Force of Will. He must not have another blue card, because he definitely would have. I would think that he would Force of Will the Sensei's Divining Top in this situation. Top's really strong. I guess I'm more keen on Force of Willing Top than most people. I definitely don't usually in the Miracles matchup, but that's because they run 4 tops. If your opponent is only playing a couple of tops, and you're playing a grindy deck, and you're trying to grind out the opponent, it's really awkward to just let it resolve, because they'll gain so much value out of it, assuming they ever draw a fetch land, which I guess is a pretty big assumption. Okay, he's snapcasting back Bolt to hit the Liliana, so that I don't ultimate next turn. It also gives him a creature to equip Batterskull to, but it prevents him from rebuying Batterskull here. So he's going to Bolt me, redirect to Liliana, keep me from ultimating, and that's just fine. We're going to draw Dryad Arbor. And I guess we could, like, play Dryad Arbor and uptick Liliana. I think that's really ambitious, though. Although we would get his last card out of his hand. Did his Ponder shuffle or not? Because he definitely pondered that turn, too. He chose not to shuffle his library. Okay. Well, maybe the card he drew off the Ponder was the Snapcaster Mage. Maybe I should just, like, draw the 5-3 and the Dryad Arbor and run both of them out. Because I can tap the top to do so. I think that's actually a reasonable line. Because then I have two bodies. And I don't really have to care about its Snapcaster. Yeah, it's kind of a weird line. But I think I'm going to take it. So we play Dryad Arbor. Uptick. Get the last card out of his hand. It was a Jace. Pretty happy about that uptick. Draw a card. It's Titania. We have no targets for Titania because we're real good at magic. And play it as a vanilla 5-3 and just like a worst Thragtusk. This is the worst I've seen Titania ever be. Usually there's a fetch, or like it's late game and I have a couple fetches in play and I just green sun for it and it's like 15 power for 5 mana or something like that. When it's kind of not ideal here. So he draws a card. And I hope his line is to just suit up Snapcaster. Kind of looks like that's what's happening here. So this is very good for me because he attacks the Liana. I block with Dryad Arbor, and yeah, this happens. So that was special. We redraw top, play top, spin top, and find Maelstrom Pulse. So that's exciting. There's an Eternal Witness under it. Yeah, so even though he fired off Dig Through Time this game, we are just outgrinding the bejeebus out of him. So I'm going to uptick and then tap this to draw Pulse and Pulse the probably the Snapcaster, actually. We could also Pulse the Batterskull, which is kind of hard to deal with otherwise, but I think our board kind of deals with the Batterskull. He has to like rebuy it and stuff. It's kind of wonky. Oh, he's like, why is he pulsing my Snapcaster? What's going on? But we should get him to a position where we Eternal Witness back Pulse, or something of that nature. Yeah, and every turn we can just draw top, replay top, uptick Liliana. Oh, he's got plays. Hardcast Force of Will. Yep, okay. So we got our Force of Will, but we know our next draw is Eternal Witness. And we're attacking him pretty low here. So we can draw Eternal Witness, and maybe even just Witness back Abrupt Decay. I don't know. Thinking about ultimating the Liliana and letting him choose between Tundra, Batterskull, Jit, or the rest of his lands. Okay, he just packs it in. So we were kind of behind for most of that game, but Liliana is a pretty good card. it's pretty good in this deck. It's kind of what this deck is doing. So that happened. We managed to get value out of our Titania somehow. I'm not sure how that happened. I'm free to admit I have no clue how we got a 5-3 out of this thing with no fetches or whatever. Attack into your Dryad Arbor, whatever. Yeah, Skeletal Scrying seems really good. can be like our answer to dig through time, like a draw five or what have you. He's playing a Swords to Plowshares deck. Let's see here. I think I'm gonna cut an Abrupt Decay, bring in another Maelstrom Pulse. Maelstrom Pulse kills Jace. It's really good against Jace. It's solid against his equipment. And then we have Thragtusk, and Thragtusk is really good against one-for-one removal spells or Jace the Mind Sculptor. Like, Jace Bounce isn't an effective answer. It's good against sweepers, too. He showed a Supreme Verdict, and Thragtusk is very good in that situation. We could cut a Deed, and we can also cut a Scavenging Ooze. Now we're at 59, and then either bring in, like, Kitchen Finks or the Hymn to Turok. Probably the Finks, maybe? I don't know. Just another body to pressure his Jaces and stuff. That's all I'm really worried about. I think I'm going to bring in the Hymn. I'm going to try the Hymn. There's also a Reclamation Sage in the board, but I don't think equipment is really what we're worried about in this matchup. Maybe. Maybe it is. I mean, it's a solid tutor target, but we can always, like, Deed for the World or something to get rid of a Batterskull if we really have to. I actually think, like, the discard is better against equipment than one-for-one removal spells. Alright, let's try this. Got 60 cards here. Oh god, there's only a few matches going on.